This guy, if you just subscribed recently, you might not know him, but you're about to get to know him. If you haven't subscribed, I don't understand you. I just don't get it. I try so hard. Why don't you subscribe? Anyway, guys, we're gonna show you something really special. I wanted to show something that usually you wouldn't get in my channel because I usually do things on my own. Since I have him here, we're gonna do a one bachata move that is a little bit more advanced. So that's why we're doing only one move. We want to break it down in detail so you would actually be able to pick it up just by watching this video. We will make sure to explain everything in pure detail to make sure that the girl is safe and the guys know exactly what they're doing. All leaders and followers, whoever is doing it, right? So without further ado, you are about to see how to lead this complicated, very cool bachata move. Okay guys, so let's get started. Point number one is the actual preparation for the move. I'm gonna let Dren take over. We're gonna start with the basic and then he will tell you the rest.
Yeah, so the preparation happens on the eighth of the basic that we're gonna do. And what it's gonna be is it's gonna be a lift. We're gonna lift our partner up onto her tiptoes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so let's take a look. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah? So I scoop her up on 8.
Exactly. So now, very important here, and I am assuming you already know this. If you don't, there's gonna be a video in the description box about the frame, okay? So if you don't know about the connections on the frame, please check out that video as well because I don't want to spend time talking about that. But without the frame, followers, you're not gonna be able to feel what is happening. You'll be just standing there, your arms come up and you feel nothing. So you have to make sure you push those shoulders down so when you feel a lift, you don't go with your arms, you go with your tippy toe. And one more super important bit is to make sure no matter where your legs are at that moment, if you feel a lift up, you collect your both legs tight and as you tippy toe, immediately engage all of your body. Make sure there's a little bit of tension because remember, whenever you are having tension, you'll be lighter. If you relax, you're heavier. Mm. Heavy, not good for this particular move. So should we show it one more time?
Yep. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, what I like to do is, I kind of have like a rule. If you want to bring your partner up, you must slightly go down first. Mm. So it's almost like you actually doing a little dip before you go up. Mm-hmm. So watch again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm exaggerating. Up. Yep.
I like that rule. And that's the tip number one. Okay. Tip number two. What happens after the eight?
So we've gone here. Now we're going to initiate the lean. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to step back and I'm going to open to my left side just a little bit with my leg. So watch here. Now notice I'm keeping my right leg nice and straight. Her body is leaning against mine and my left leg is bent. Yeah, and I'm holding the connection here. Yeah, I bring it back up.
It's not easy to demonstrate that slow, I'm just saying.
Yeah, you don't want to stay there for too long.
No, we're just demonstrating this slow, right?
A good quad workout. Okay, so I'll show you again. So up on the eight and step back and lean. Okay.
Do you want to shift from a different direction as well?
Yes. So this direction is a little bit easier because I'm not just going straight back here. I'm actually opening my side a little bit to my partner because I want her to connect here for what's going to come next. Okay. So tip one, up, and now tip two and lean against her. Yeah. Cool? Mm,
cool. Now, for the followers, many things, okay? First of all, You gotta make sure you are holding your own weight as much as possible. Frame down and keep that frame, but also make sure your shoulders don't come up, push them down and engage your core, engage your legs, your bum, everything is squeezing. And those toes, especially on the floor, make sure you don't end up on the tippy toe right there because your legs start sliding. So when you wanna make sure you have like a good piece of bulk of the feet, so when you're leaning, it actually gets stuck to the floor more. But actually it's a good point for the guys as well, the leaders. If you're taking a super big step, you have to estimate, sometimes it's so big that she has no choice and her legs do slide a little bit on the floor. So just maintain that distance, you know, with consideration. And now followers, the important bit is here, when he takes that step back, what we don't want to do is this. Leave the bum out, right? The whole point, the only way this is gonna work, if you relax your hip and connect with his side of the hip as well. So he goes on the tippy toe for me, he takes me back, and look, my hip relaxes, right? But my legs are not sliding. So you gotta kinda find the right position for both of you. It's teamwork situation. And one more little thing, guys, when you're taking a step back, if you notice, Dren's back is not leaning back.
Yeah.
He's keeping his
like
back.
Right there, game over.
Game over. And it's also, it's good to protect yourself as well, you know? Yeah. These things for the lower back and everything, it's not really, you know, that easy to do. So make sure you keep your body straight when you take that step. There's a line here, but you don't lean across your line, right?
So what's gonna happen is, essentially like her tummy area is gonna, and her hips are gonna push forward and rest against my side. That's why I don't want to lean back. Because if I do, she's gonna come further down, and then she's too low down, and when the next bit comes, it's not gonna work. And then my last tip is, followers, please don't throw yourself at your follower.
Gently. Yeah.
Just because he's lifted you up doesn't mean my moment has come, and throw yourself. So just let him actually control and lead you into the lean. Yeah, keep that connection so that we can help control.
Let's show that bit again.
Yeah. So lift up, and because she's giving me connection, I can really slow it down. Yeah.
And that is the tip number two.
Two.
All right. So now tip number three.
So we've gone into the lean. Now, how do we get back out of the lean?
Exactly.
Okay, so what we're gonna do is, without a partner first, just to show you, I'm here, imagine she's leaning on me. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna give a little bit of a huh with the hip.
Oh Lord.
But remember, she's on our side, so it's not the huh,
oh,
but it's
ooh
a huh.
It's becoming dangerous.
Yeah, so it's actually the side, okay? So let's show. So tip one, and part two here. And now, three. Yeah? And voila.
So now, follow us. If you notice, when we go on the tip two, we lean on him. As his hip goes, I don't do any steps or anything. What I do, I just allow the hip to go and I keep my frame where it is. Because I keep my frame, it puts me in this compromising position. Again, you're not gonna stay there long, don't worry. So now I am looking up. I'm waiting for the next part. The important bit is this position right here. My legs are straight. If they're bent, it doesn't look as nice. So we want to have that arch. And there's many things that can happen in this, believe it or not, position as well. So you really have to make sure you keep that frame down, you're looking up, and you have straight legs, and your boom boom is arching, yes?
Yeah. And then also, for the guys, when we're pushing with the hip, we're not going straight away with our partner. We need to give space so that when her boom boom goes back, she's actually space for her to keep her upper body bent down.
Exactly.
Otherwise, it's just her face goes straight into her chest.
Show the version that we don't want. This is what you shouldn't do.
Okay.
Can you even do it? You see? Too intimate.
Yeah, so this is like broken teeth, you know, broken jaw. Maybe the chin hits the collarbone and that's it.
Yeah.
Game over. You know, so we want to leave the dance floor with all our teeth.
Yes, and basically he creates the space with the frame.
Exactly. That's why it's just a pop. So you're actually bringing it back and then you're holding the position, so you're still keeping down.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Tip number four.
Right, so we're coming out from the lean. What we want to do is we're trying to keep our partner still down. So we, the leaders, we actually control this movement. All right, so here, lift and lean. Now, when I actually push off, I'm keeping my palms rotated down towards the floor. Boom. So I'm actually, you can see my palms are facing down. She's giving me the connection and I can then start to lead her back. Okay? And then this is essentially as far as we're going to go for this tip. But see, I have control here. Keeping the palms down. As soon as my palms rotate up, that's it. It's finished. She's got the freedom to come back up. But for this move that we're doing, we're trying to delay that for a little bit. And tip number five, it's going to come in a bit.
Exactly. So follow us. As you notice, when I come out from the hip, there's going to be an arch. The next part, he starts bringing you up, but it's a scoop. So you get that little bit of a hump in the upper body. Because he, as I say, there's so many things that could happen with this position. He could bring you back. Then you go with your head up. When he pushes you back up, the head goes down into a hump. So here is super important to develop this movement as you feel it. And that hump goes, what we don't want to do is go just up, right? We want to make sure that it's the graduate. Head goes down and the head is going to be the last one to come up. So to get that hump before everything else, super important. Yes?
Yes.
Yes. Final tip, let's finish this off. Tip number five.
Yeah, so now we're finishing with our lovely little head flick that we want to achieve, a little bit of extra styling. So, lift, lean, push away. Now, as we come up, I'm still holding down, and then at the end, you rotate your wrists to bring the shoulder blades forward. Yeah, that's forwards, this way.
Yeah. How do the hands actually, go?
So, your hands are here, and as you bring her up, then you rotate so that your palms are now facing towards you, okay?
If you, this is a good point, if you followers don't feel that extra, like a little bit more intention in the let's finish with the head momentum, then you just gradually come up, don't flick your head. Not every move has that. Exactly. Some just goes gradually up and you continue dancing. So you really have to feel it. You don't feel it, don't do it. Yes, that's all it is. But if you feel that extra bit, this is when you do your head flick. And you will know it's coming because he will slow down and stop that gradual come up to have that extra bit. So now, how do we do actually the head?
Let's get in the position again.
So now, here, as I'm here and I feel that shoulder flick situation right there, I'm gonna relax my head. I apologize, need more space now to explain to you people. So guys, I'm gonna just here soften my knees a little bit. So when I do the head, I can throw it and I can arch a little bit as well. What I don't like doing is the head with my straight body, because then just the head goes and it's just a little bit strange, right?
The body likes to follow.
Exactly. So I just softened my knees a little bit before the final head situation. It's just styling. You don't have to do it so much that it actually hurts you. Nothing is supposed to hurt. So you're just allowing the momentum happen. And anytime you're using your neck in such a way, I recommend relaxing the shoulders. When you put the shoulders down and you do the head, it doesn't go. So you have to soften your shoulders, and when he flicks them back, that softening of the shoulders is just a little bit higher than usual for that little bit of momentum. Then the head goes without hurting you. Now, I always said to everybody, my neck is not as flexible as other people's. I had some neck injuries. So if you can go a little bit more, that's great. I can't. But it's not a necessity. It's just creating that style, giving a little bit of extra flair, and if you have your hair out, you can do a bit of a whip. Don't hurt your man. But that's a nice thing to do. Should we do it again?
Yep. So up and lean, push away and flick.
And bachata.
Yep.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And now you got the whole combo. Thank you so much for watching, guys. If you enjoyed this complicated move and you'd like to see more, just say bring Dren back. If you want to see more complicated stuff, he's a strong man. We can do some lifts, we can do some tricks. And guys, we're gonna do them really safely. I'm gonna explain the detail and appropriate times when to use it. So if you really want it, let me know in the comments below. In the meantime, give us a little thumbs up and also subscribe if you really enjoyed it. And guys, as I said, there's gonna be a video. There's gonna be a video as well here above us to practice a little bit more your frame in bachata. And if you dance salsa, there's gonna be a salsa video for the frame as well. So thank you so much and welcome to the room.